See the question. Once I read out this question. A factory shed is to be constructed using a truss as shown. So this is the truss shown in the figure. Basically, this is a how truss. Okay, this is a how truss having a span of 12 meter. See here, the span of the truss is 12 meter and spacing of the truss is 4 meter. It means in the diagram we can see only one truss, but there exists some other trusses in the plane perpendicular to the plane of this board. Okay, there exists some other trusses which are in the plane perpendicular to this board. Okay. Now what is asking? Determine the design loads at the nodes. See here. Nodes. Nodes means these points. Okay. At the joints. Okay. At the joints. Nodes. Due to live load and wind load for an intermediate truss. Assume design wind pressure. So these were the informations. So design wind pressure basically we represent with PD, right? So design wind pressure PD. And CPE is nothing but external pressure coefficient. And CPI is a internal pressure coefficient. So related to this already we have discussed previously or briefly. Okay, in our previous discussions on calculation of wind load, we have discussed briefly about the CPE and CPI. Now in this question, let us see how to use those coefficients for calculating the wind load. Is that okay? Now this is the question and this is the diagram given in the question. Now it's asking us to find the design loads at the nodes due to live load and wind load. Clear everyone? So for that we need to find the theta. So this is the theta for this truss. As I said, this truss is a how truss. So here let me write. So this is a how truss, double pitched how truss, and this is the theta. Okay, this is the theta means slope angle. Okay, that is the theta, slope angle. To find the theta, we make use of tan theta. As we know, tan theta is nothing but opposite. So, what is opposite here? Rise. So, 2.5 upon half of the span, that is 6. Clear everyone? So, tan theta is equal to 2.5 upon 6. Upon simplifying, we will get that theta value as 22.62 degree. So, theta value as a 22.62 degree. Now, as this theta is greater than 10 degree, we know the procedure for calculating the live load, which is what already discussed. Okay, as theta is greater than 10 degree, now as per IS 875 part 2, now live load, okay, live load on purlin. And if you observe the diagram, so these were the angle purlins. And on the top of the angle purlin, there exists a roof sheeting. Of course, they are not required, but those detailing were mentioned in the question. Okay, those detailing were mentioned in the diagram of the question. Okay, so live load on the purlin. As we know, angle is greater than 10 degree, then live load on purlin is equal to 0.75 minus 0.02 theta minus 10, right? So now zero, upon simplifying it, 0.75 minus 0.02. Here theta is nothing but 22.62. So 22.62 minus 10, it is 12.62. Is that okay? Upon simplifying, we'll get live load on purlin as, okay, we'll get the live load on purlin as 0.4976 kilonewton per meter. Is that clear? Now based on this value, we'll calculate live load on truss. Okay. So now live load on truss. As we know, live load on truss is 2/3 of the live load on the purlin. It means 2/3 of this value, 0.4976, which comes out to be 0.332 kilonewton per meter. Okay, 332 kilonewton per meter. That is the live load on the truss per unit area. Okay, per unit plan area. Now for calculating the total live load on the truss, we need to multiply this value with total plan area. But that is not the question here. What is the question here? Is asking us to find the loads at nodes. For that, we need to consider this double pitched how truss as a two panels. It means this is one panel. Okay, up to here means half of this truss has one panel and other half of this truss has other panel. It means we need to consider that given truss as a panels. Then only we can able to find or we can able to show that load on the panel points or at the panel points. Is that okay? Hence, Hence, for calculating the total live load or for calculating the live load, we need to multiply this value with half of the plan area, not the total plan area. It means for calculating the reactions, we need to multiply this value with total plan area. Okay, but for calculating the live load or but for showing the loads on the panel points, we need to multiply this value with half of the plan area. Is that okay? Total live load on each panel. As I said, we divide this double feature hoe truss into two panels. That is half of the span as a one panel and other half as another panel. Okay, so total live load on each panel is how much? 0.332 into half of the plan area. So what is half of the plan area? So total span is 12 meter. Now half in it is 6 and spacing of the truss is how much? 4. So now 6 into 4, 0.332 into 6 into 4, we'll get total live load on the each panel. So that 0.332 into 6 into 4 comes out to be 7.968 kilonewton. So this is the total live load on the each panel. Now we want live load on the pan, on the nodes of the each panel. So now for this half panel, see here, for this half panel, how many nodes are there? Okay, or how many points are there? So nodes are nothing but joints are points. So how many panel points are there? See here, let me count. This is 1, this is 2, and this is 3. And end nodes or end points are considered as a half, not complete. Okay, so this is half and this is also half. So total how many points are there for each panel? So 1, 2, 3 and half plus half, total 4. So total 4 panel points are there, or total 4 nodes are there for each panel. Now load on each point is how much? Live load on each panel point. As the four panel points are there, hence this value is to be multiplied divided with 4. That is 7.968 divided by 4. So this value comes out to be 1.992 kilonewton. Okay, 1.992 kilonewton. So this is the load on each panel point. Okay, this is the load on each panel point. Now here for each panel, two types of nodes are there, or two types of points are there. This is the end point, which are considered as a half, and these are the full panel points. Okay, these are the full panel points. Therefore, live load on LL means live load. So live load on FPP. So full panel point. FPP. So FPP means a full panel point is equal to 1.992 kilonewton, and live load on end panel point. Okay, end panel point, that is considered as EPP, end panel point, is how much? Half of this value. So it is half of this value, 1.992 by 2. Okay, 1.992 by 2. So that comes out to be 0.996 kilonewton. So these were the loads on panel points. Okay, these were the live loads on panel points of the truss. Okay, so first you take it down. After that, I will show that live loads on each panel point of given double pitched hoe truss. Okay, so first you take it down. Later that I rub it and I will show the live load on each panel point. So that is what our question. So determine the design loads at the nodes. Nodes means panel points. Okay, nodes means panel points of that given truss. Okay. So first, let us show the live load, and later we will see how to calculate the wind load, and that wind load also we will show on the notes. Okay. Once again, I am going to draw this diagram. as the live load and wind load always acts in vertically downward direction. Okay, vertically downward direction. So this is how the loads are going to act. For this panel, okay. Now intermediate nodes are considered as a full panel points. Okay, intermediate nodes are considered as a full panel point. Now what is the load on intermediate nodes or full panel points? That is 1.992 kilonewton. Here also 1.992 kilonewton. Here it is 1.992 kilonewton. Is that okay? Now here also, let me show you also 1.992 kilonewton. 1.992 kilonewton. 1.992 kilonewton. Is that clear? Now for end panel point, what is the load? 0.996 kilonewton, right? 0.996 kilonewton. Here also 0.996 kilonewton. Now for this panel, for this panel point or for this node, there exists 0.099 kilonewton from this panel, and from this panel also same load. It means 0.996 plus 0.996. So total is how much? 1.992 kilonewton. Okay, so these are the live loads on nodes. Okay, these are the live loads on the nodes of the given truss. Is that okay? So first you take it up, and as I said, later we will see how to calculate the wind load and the and we represent that wind load on the given truss. Okay, so take it down. First take this diagram. Okay. So coming to the wind load, WL, we represent with F. So formula for F, as already discussed, is CPE minus CPI into A into PD, right? Okay. And of course, we have discussed the formula for PD. And of course, in that formula for PD, there exists some other term, that is PZ. And of course, we have seen the formula for PZ and everything. But in this question, all those things what we have discussed are not at all required. The reason, directly the PD value was given. Okay, PD value was given. How much is the PD value? 1500 Newton per mm square. And what is the area to be considered here? Surface area. It means this inclined. Okay, this means this inclined length. How much is inclined length? For calculating this inclined length, we make use of right angle triangle concept. So this is 6 meter and this is 2.5 meter, right? Now how much this one? This is a hypotenuse. So it is under root 2.5 square plus 6 square. So find it comes out to be 6.5 meter. Okay, 6.5 meter. Therefore, surface area A comes out to be 6.5 into 4 mm, 4 meter square. Is that okay? So that is the area to be used for calculating the wind load. Okay, for calculating the wind load, this is the area to be used. And one more thing we are aware of that. Okay, one more thing we are aware of it. That is, this wind force always acts perpendicular to the truss. Okay, perpendicular to this inclined face of the truss. Or you can say perpendicular to the rafter. Okay, perpendicular to the principal rafter. Okay, so this is the area. Now PD is also known to us. Now coming to this. CPE minus CPI, right? So what is the value of CPE? That is external pressure coefficient minus 0.7. okay, now here for CPI, two values are there, that is plus 0.2 and minus 0.2. so we'll take the two values into the consideration, and out of those two, whichever is maximum, that we use in our calculation of wind load. So how much it is? Minus 0.5. so if you use minus 0.2, how much it is? Minus 0.9, right? So here, which is maximum here? This one is maximum. Okay, and that too, one more concept. If this coefficient is negative, it indicates that wind pressure is going to produce suction. If it is positive, it is going to create some pressure. But as here the coefficients summation or difference comes out to be negative, therefore this wind pressure or wind force, what we are going to calculate, or wind load, okay, what we are going to obtain, is going to create suction in that truss. Okay, means away. Okay, it is going to act away from the truss, not towards the truss. Okay, so here I will write that suction. Negative indicates suction. Okay, negative indicates suction. Now wind load is equal to, wind load F is equal to minus 0.9 into area is how much? 6.5 into 4 into 1500, right? So this is how we are going to get a wind load or wind force. So how much this comes out to be? So this comes out to be minus 35.1 kilonewton. So as I said, negative indicates suction. It means that wind load acts away from the truss, not towards the truss. Even though the wind load direction is perpendicular to the principal rafter, but that perpendicular direction is away, not towards the truss. Is that okay? Keep that in mind. Now, this wind load, WLN, FPP means full panel point. Already we have discussed what is full panel point and what is end panel point. So this comes out to be 35.1, minus 35.1 by 4. Okay, minus 35.1 by 4. It comes out to be minus 8.775 kilonewton. Okay, minus 8.775 kilonewton. Now, wind load on end panel point is half of this. 8.775 by 2. How much it is? 3875. Is that okay? So these were the live loads on full panel point and end panel point. So first you take it on, later I will show these particular wind loads on notes of the given truss. Okay, notes of this double pitched how truss. Okay, so first you take them, the wind load. So this is how to calculate the wind load. Okay, this is how to calculate the wind load. Of course, the detailed procedure for calculating the wind load was already discussed in our conceptual part. But here it is very easy. Okay, there in the discussion we have seen so many formulas and factors. But in this question, no need of using all those factors because the value of design wind pressure was given directly. Clear everyone? Right. That is the reason our calculation part becomes very simple. Okay, you take it on. Later I will show the those wind loads. Just now we have discussed wind load will act perpendicular to the plane of this principal rafter and that too away from it. Okay, away from the truss. So this is how the wind load will act. Now for full panel point, how much the wind load is acting? 8.775. Okay, 8.775 kilonewton. Clear? Now for end panel point, how much it is? 4.3875 kilonewton. 4.3875 kilonewton. Is that okay? 4.3875 kilonewton. So this is how to show or how to represent wind load for this question or in this question for the given conditions. Okay, is that clear everyone? So this is how to represent the wind load on nodes. And in the previous case, we have seen how to represent the live load on the nodes of the given truss. Okay, so this question is completed. You take it on.